It's a weekday, so we do have a lot more of our supporters and people coming down right now. But what you see in front of you is a very resilient group of tenants who have been on the longest rent strike in San Francisco history. Now, this has been going on since August of last year. Our families, our neighbors, we face rent increases anywhere between 30 and 300%. Now, this is a community that has not healed since the times of civic redevelopment. This is a community, members of which have lost their homes, members of which have lost their Victorians, and they were given Midtown as a place where they can then live, pay off their mortgage, and participate in the life of the city. We've done that, didn't we?
Yes!
We paid off our mortgage.
Yes!
In 2007.
Yes!
We have a Board of Supervisors resolution, 32507, that calls for the turnover of the Midtown property to its tenants.
Yes!
What do we have instead of that? Instead of that, Mo decided to break the lease with a resident-ran nonprofit board. Mo broke that. Mo gave the lease to Mercy Housing. Now, that is supposed to be a charitable organization. They were supposed to be a nonprofit. In our experience, Mercy has no mercy.
They immediately
instituted draconian rent increases. Our rents have went up threefold. Our rents have went up over 300%.
Yes.
That is criminal. In the year 2016, to impose rent increases of such magnitude upon a working class community.
Yes. Wrong.
Look at us.
Wrong.
We don't work in tech. We don't code. I don't work for Google. We drive your buses. We deliver your mail. And now all of a sudden, a lot of my neighbors in the autumn of the years have no security. They're worried. We have people who died, didn't we?
Yes.
We have people who died.
We have no security. They canceled our security.
And you're talking about non-displacement? Well, there was displacement. People moved to Tacoma to live 6 feet under forever. That is horrible. That is absolutely horrible. So I would
keep
like
it
to
up.
Do...
Keep it up!
What
keep
I would
it
like,
up!
You got it, brother! You got it!
The city is a strong landlord!
What I would like
the city
to...
is a strong landlord!
Absolutely! So we have
keep
is we have a number
keep
of folks...
Keep it up!
You got it, brother! You got it! We have been engaged in action for the past 2.5 years.
2.5 years!
There are hundreds and thousands of people in the city of San Francisco who have been displaced, people about whom you hear every day. But we're different. We're Midtown. We're together. We're united. We present a unified front.
Yeah.
Now, what I'd like to do is call my sister-in-arms, Phyllis Bowie. Phyllis Bowie is a long-term resident at the Midtown Park Apartments. She is a United States Air Force veteran. She was an officer. And she has a few words to say for us. Go on.
They took our rent control. We had rent paid off our loan in 2007. And then what they did was they broke our lease and gave it to Mercy Housing. And basically what that meant is the residents, after they paid off the loan, have no say-so. Once again, no meetings, no say-so. We're dictated to. New property managers came in. We had to sign them. We were forced to sign a lease, which meant we had no rent control. They took away our rent control. They took away our security. We've had 3 seniors die because they refused to abide by the American Disability Act.
We have no access to three floors. The building was built in 1968. The city refuses. They neglected for years, and there's repairs that need to be done. They're refusing to do the repairs. They're calling us that it's our problem, and we need to just be quiet and let them get along with their plan. Their plan has nothing to do with ownership. You guys, we bought into this. We signed a lease, some of us, me, 22 years ago. Some of us, 35, 40 years ago. And the lease said, your rent is going to purchase. You're going to purchase your apartment. Your rent, part of it, is going to purchase. Once we paid it off, we kept our plan.
That's
the city has another plan. They want housing to be demolished. You will be displaced. They will be displaced. They increase our rent. That's another way of displacement. They say it's not displacement, but if your rent went up 300% and you've been living for 20 years with the assumption that you had rent control at least, that's just criminal. That's the city and county of San Francisco. We're the only property that the mayor's office of housing owns. And this is how they treat tenants. This is how they treat tenants that have been in the Western Addition for over 40 years, which now the Western Addition, there are no people that look like us that live in Midtown in our community. Why can't the city prove good on their promise in 1968 that this is a place that will not displace people no matter what your income, no matter what your race, no matter what your ethnicity? Midtown is a safe place to be in your own. Why did they stop doing that? Why are they refusing to talk to us? They're refusing to talk to us. We said, come on, you have the control to give us back rent control, and then let's talk about ownership. They will not talk to us. So we do this. We come to the streets. We ask for media to do it. All we want to do is meet. Give us back our home, stop the increases, and give us rent control. This is the richest city in the nation. This is the richest city in the nation. And the one property that this city owns, it does not want to pay anything to repair, pay anything for the seniors that live there. They have to walk upstairs. I watch my seniors panting, knowing that they're going to be another of the three that have passed with the stress of living at Midtown. God bless Midtown. I believe that justice will prevail. We are not going anywhere. You can make calls. You can close the doors. You can shut it. You can lock it. We are still here. The community is talking nationally and internationally. Save Midtown.
All right, Phyllis, thank you very much.
Here you go, brother. This is the press release.
All right. Now, what you heard from Phyllis is a very compelling story. Her story can be echoed by any one of the tenants at Midtown who have been victims of persecution, who have been victimized, who have been discriminated against, who have been marginalized. You look at our community, now there's absolutely no way that Mercy Housing would be doing this to us if we were any other color. That is a damn fact. That is a fact.
Yes, that's right.
What we have is, Mary, you want to take up the word? Come on, honey. All right. Now, what we're here for is we're asking for something very basic. We have a lawsuit against the city of San Francisco. This is a historical lawsuit that was launched after the largest petition for rent control in San Francisco history has been denied. We launched it. It was said that it couldn't be done. There was no attorney that wanted to work with us. I personally called over 100 attorneys, and because we were dealing with Mo, because we were dealing with the city, no attorney wanted to take our case. What's going on, brother? Labor night, everybody. Justice for Mario Woods Coalition. Give it up. What's going on? I see a couple of more people. I see a good friend, Chase. D5 Action Group out there. How you doing, Chase? All right. I see my brother, Tony Roberts. How you doing? Of San Francisco. We have people like this who were born here, who were raised here,
and I want your men here. As our lawsuit is moving forward, the city is throwing everything at its disposal to put an end to it. They're trying to bleed us dry. They're trying to make it so we drop our lawsuit. We've asked the community, and the community has responded. We raised over $4,000 in two different fundraisers. Our friends and neighbors from the Fillmore, St. John Orthodox Church, D5 Action Group, our friends and neighbors came down and they made donations to make sure that our fight, the fight continues. Now, I would like to do it. As we move forward, we're here for one very specific reason. We're demanding that Mayor's Office of Housing restores rent control protection for the petitioners. What do we want? Rent control. When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Rent control.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Rent control.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Rent control.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Rent control.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Rent control.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Rent control.
When do we want? Of letters from different management companies that say, hey, your rent increase is happening, but it's happening according to rent control legislation. And that is something that we're asking for today. Not asking for anything more than that. Now, I'd like to introduce to you is another veteran at the Midtown Park Apartments. Now, this gentleman has been instrumental from the very beginning, a former vice president of the Midtown Park Apartments nonprofit board. Donald Griggs, you see Donald Griggs, everybody?
The first thing I want to thank you guys for coming out and supporting us. We're not only Midtown alone. We have support from the San Francisco Labor Council. Local 214, letter carrier union in the city, and a number of other unions in the city.
That's right.
That the city promised that once the mortgage was paid off, that we would be either co-op or outright owners. Right now, the city is reneging on their promise. There was a sweetheart deal with Mercy Housing. It was almost like they handed it to them. The Sisters of Mercy. Mercy has no mercy.
Mercy has no mercy.
Mercy came in, and they thought that they were going to be able to set the rules down and control us, but they were not aware that we were able to organize and let our feelings be known and our demands be known. The city has been an absentee landlord, which they acknowledge. Publicly, they acknowledge that they have been an absentee landlord, and they said they were sorry. But that's not good enough. Shame on San Francisco. You would think that San Francisco, progressive city that they say we are, that if they own a complex in this city, it should be manicured lawns, it should be gleaning, it should be the best place to live. We shouldn't have to have rent control if we're all by the city of San Francisco. If they acknowledge that we've been on rent control for the duration that we've lived there, but not now since they gave it to Mercy. San Francisco, do the right thing. Do the right thing. Do the right thing. We want to let Olson Lee know that he's not going to get away with it. We demand that Midtown become our property, that we either become co-op or outright owners. That is our demand. And we're thanking you guys for coming out and supporting us.
Now, I just want to say thank you to Donald. Because of him, we've been able to organize and have a place for meetings on a weekly basis. Every Thursday, 6:30 to 7:30, Midtown Tenants Association
That's right. We are the Tenants Association. How you doing, Juanita?
Hi.
All right, sister. Always good to see you. Always good to see you. It is because of people like Juanita Clay. It is because of people like Aida and, of course, the Watkins family that we made the strides that we had. And at this point, I want to ask the brother who stood side by side with us, not only on the Midtown issue, but also on a number of other social justice issues, like Justice for Mario Woods. We've been together on the front lines of the 3-5, of the hunger strike for justice. We got Tony Roberts. Tony, come on up here, brother. Thank you.
Hey!
We see Tony Roberts, everybody. We are a circle. We are a circle of resistance. We are a circle that connects the dots with gentrification, police violence, removal, economic violence that's been imposed on our communities. We're here in support of Midtown Apartments, the Midtown struggle, which is the struggle to keep community, to keep the fabric of community from being ripped apart.
Right.
I'm also involved with the Manila Town Heritage Foundation. That was the struggle for the International Hotel back in 1977. That was a long fight that after many, many years, the tenants rose to be victorious.
And Ed Lee was the guy who got it together.
And that's just it. You know, Ed Lee was an attorney at the time.
You got rent control for it.
And it shows just how insidious and poisonous the bureaucratic machine is. Because on the one hand, you can stand for housing justice, and on the other hand, you become exactly the injustice that you claim to stand against. So we stand here today as community together. I understand, Jay, that we're going to be going up to Most CDs.
You got it, brother.
At some point, very, very soon. And we're going to make our demands known that we can't give away community to nonprofits, which are basically just diet corporations.
They're just corporations
that are masquerading as missionaries.
Yeah.
Really, you know?
Yeah.
And they don't care really about our community. They don't care about us.
Yeah.
They are missionaries that get a paycheck. They come into our communities, take over our communities, and pretend to be doing us good. But as soon as they get the first chance, they turn around and they betray their mission statement.
Yeah.
I think the brother said a minute ago that mercy has no mercy.
Mercy
has no mercy. So Manila Town Heritage Foundation is in solidarity, standing firm with Midtown Apartments. Thank you.
Hey, brother.
Hello, brothers and sisters today.
Before you walk in, everybody.
Thank you for coming out and to support us. We said that mercy has no mercy. The mayor of housing has no mercy either.
That's right.
They are trying to get rid of us and everything. They want people with deep pockets. And we don't have deep pockets, so they took over rent control, and they want us out of here. And also, too, they're doing everything they possibly can to get us out. We are the Tenants Association. They want to bypass us and put in their own agenda, the people that they can control. You cannot control us.
We are here
to stay. And no matter what, we are here and everything. And we want them to understand that we are not going no place. And also, too, number one thing is, yesterday the mayor, he unveiled his budget. He talked about homeless. How can you talk about homeless and you're trying to make us homeless? You're going to allow, but you're trying to put us out. We're going to become homeless. In America, we should not have homeless. In San Francisco, we should not have homeless. But everybody right here are in deep pockets with the real estate and everybody else other than us. They don't care about the little man. They don't care. They just want you out. And also, too, we are not afraid. Jesus are the home we're talking about.
Yes.
I raised my children here.
Yes.
And they don't care. They don't care.
Yes.
Because if they cared, they would not try to get us out and everything.
Yes.
So anyway, we need everybody's support. Continue to support, and we will support you and do whatever we can. Because number one thing is we need to stand together, and we have to be firm in our belief. Because every time they send somebody, like now, they're sending somebody back to our place. We don't trust them, but they say, don't bring him. They're bringing him anyway. So like my thing is, we don't need that kind of, we don't need that disrespect.
Yes.
They disrespect us.
Yes.
They totally disrespect anything and everything that we do.
Yes.
And everything. But you know something? We are still standing strong.
Right.
And we will always stand strong.
Right.
So
yes.
You take care, and we have a beautiful day.
That's
Mary Wilkins, everybody.
Hey.
Mary Wilkins. She's got a lot of wisdom. She's been here at Midtown for over 40 years. I was privileged to live on the same floor with the Wilkins family, with my good brother Rufus.
Hey.
I always miss our little powwows, and every time I see Rufus, he has a lot of knowledge, a lot of wisdom, and he always calms me down and says, my brother, we're moving in the right direction as long as we all stick together.
Right.
Now, I just want you to come and say your story, my brother. Say a couple of words to these folks.
Hey! I want to say thank you, Jay, and everyone else here. I grew up with my mother who taught here. I grew up for about 40 years here, 40 years at Midtown Park Apartments. And it's a shame that we're going through what Malcolm X and James Baldwin always say. And it's Negro removal. That's what they're talking about here in San Francisco with, all of the great so-called, condominiums and so on and so forth. They want to get poor people out of here, middle-class people. That's white, brown, or whatever. Again, like what Malcolm X and James Baldwin always said, hey, it's Negro removal of all the people here. And I say to Ed Lee, who was a part of the first rent control success at Manila Apartments International, why are you changing on us? Why? And also, too, here, we are looking for rent control. And I say to the Board of Supervisors, the assemblymen and women, as well as the state senators who are running, as well as the governor who are running in 2018, the most important thing is people's housing in San Francisco.
That's right.
Nobody else, you can get money from Facebook, you can get money from Ron Conway all you want.
Yes.
But Ron Conway and Facebook don't really care about the little people. You got to understand that. So more people here in San Francisco need to understand that it's affecting you and what's going on. Again, I wanted to say again, Mr. Ron Conway is not nobody care about you. Mr. Facebook doesn't care about you. I don't care what they say in the newspapers. I don't care what they say, because the most important thing here is rent control. It's affecting everybody in San Francisco. You can go to Marina, but mainly at Midtown Park Apartments. This is a part, it's a great part of the city, and they want to move everyone out to put in these Google buses, these Genentech buses, go to Starbucks to hang out, the lattes of the world. So, we are fighting for our homes. I like to have a latte too, but I want to have it at my home too. We're under rent control. So here in San Francisco, mayors all over the housing, stop doing the dirty work of all these big developers, all these scams, Mr. Conway, Mr. Facebook, Mr. whoever, or Mrs. whoever, that's all you care about. So, again, rent control from Midtown Park Apartment. And again, thank you for all the great wisdom and all the people that's around.
The progressive heart of this city is not dead. And I think it's right about this time, Donald. What do you think? Then maybe we go off to, maybe what we'll do is, you'll take the photographers with you and deliver the letter to Director Olson Lee. And what we'll do here, us folks, we'll call a district supervisor and we're going to demand that she restores a rent control protection for the Midtown Park Apartments. How does that sound?
Yay!
All right, wonderful. Woo! All right, thank you.
Woo!
Folks, the members of the press, please follow Donald inside. He will deliver a letter on behalf of the Midtown Park Tenants Association. Thank you very much for coming, everybody.
Woo!